Rolling Stone is an American monthly magazine that focuses on popular culture. It was founded in San Francisco, California, in 1967 by Jane Winner, who is still the magazine's publisher, and the music critic Ralph J. Gleason. It was first known for its musical coverage of rock music and for political reporting by Hunter S. Thompson. In the 1990s, the magazine broadened and shifted its focus to a younger readership interested in youth-oriented television shows, film actors, and popular music. It has returned to its traditional mix of content, including music, entertainment, and politics. The first magazine was released in 1967 and featured John Lennon on the cover. It is known for provocative photography and its cover photos, featuring musicians, politicians, athletes, and actors. In addition to its print version in the United States, it publishes content through rollingstone.com and numerous international editions. Penske Media Corporation is the current owner of Rolling Stone, purchasing 51% of the magazine in 2017 and the remaining 49% in 2019. History. 1967 to 1979, founding and early history. Rolling Stone magazine was founded in San Francisco in 1967 by Jan Winner and Ralph Gleason. To get it off the ground, Winner borrowed $7,500 from his own family and from the parents of his soon-to-be wife, Jane Sandelli Iam. The first issue was released on November 9, 1967 and featured John Lennon on the cover. It was in newspaper format with a lead article on the Monterey Pop Festival. The cover price was 25 cents, equivalent to $1.88 in 2016. In the first issue, Winner explained that the title of the magazine referred to the 1950 blues song Rolling Stone, recorded by Muddy Waters, and Bob Dylan's hit single Like a Rolling Stone. You're probably wondering what we're trying to do. It's hard to say, sort of a magazine and sort of a newspaper. The name of it is Rolling Stone, which comes from an old saying, a rolling stone gathers no moss. Muddy Waters used the name for a song he wrote. The Rolling Stones took their name from Muddy's song. Like a Rolling Stone was the title of Bob Dylan's first rock and roll record. We have begun a new publication reflecting what we see are the changes in rock and roll and the changes related to rock and roll. Jan Winner, Rolling Stone, November 9, 1967, p. 2. Some authors have attributed the name solely to Dylan's hit single, At Ralph Gleason's suggestion, Winner named his magazine after a Bob Dylan song. Rolling Stone initially identified with and reported the hippie counterculture of the era. However, it distanced itself from the underground newspapers of the time, such as Berkeley Barb, embracing more traditional journalistic standards and avoiding the radical politics of the underground press. In the very first edition, Winner wrote that Rolling Stone is not just about the music, but about the things and attitudes that music embraces. In the 1970s, Rolling Stone began to make a mark with its political coverage, with the likes of gonzo journalist Hunter S. Thompson writing for the magazine's political section. Thompson first published his most famous work Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas within the pages of Rolling Stone, where he remained a contributing editor until his death in 2005. In the 1970s, the magazine also helped launch the careers of many prominent authors, including Cameron Crowe, Lester Bangs, Joe Klein, Joe Esterhaus, Ben Fong Torres, Patti Smith and P.J. O'Rourke. It was at this point that the magazine ran some of its most famous stories, including that of the Patty Hearst abduction odyssey. One interviewer, speaking for many of his peers, said that he bought his first copy of the magazine upon initial arrival on his college campus, describing it as a rite of passage. In 1977, the magazine moved its headquarters from San Francisco to New York City. Editor Jan Winner said San Francisco had become a cultural backwater. 1980 to 1999, change to entertainment magazine. Rolling Stone shifted to more of an entertainment magazine in the 1980s. It still had music as the main topic but began to increase its coverage of celebrities, films, and pop culture. It also began releasing its annual hot issue. Rolling Stone was initially known for its musical coverage and for Thompson's political reporting. In the 1990s, the magazine changed its format to appeal to a younger readership interested in youth-oriented television shows, film actors, and popular music. This led to criticism that the magazine was emphasizing style over substance. In recent years, the magazine has resumed its traditional mix of content, including in-depth political stories. It has also expanded content to include coverage of financial and banking issues. As a result, the magazine has seen its circulation increase and its reporters invited as experts to network television programs of note. 2000 to 2015, expansion of readership. After years of declining readership, the magazine experienced a major resurgence of interest and relevance with the work of two young journalists in the late 2000s, Michael Hastings and Matt Taibbi. In 2005, Dana Leslie Fields, former publisher of Rolling Stone, who had worked at the magazine for 17 years, was an inaugural inductee into the Magazine Hall of Fame. In 2009, Taibbi unleashed an acclaimed series of scathing reports on the financial meltdown of the time. He famously described Goldman Sachs as a great vampire squid. Bigger headlines came at the end of June 2010. Rolling Stone caused a controversy in the White House by publishing in the July issue an article by journalist Michael Hastings entitled, "The Runaway General," quoting criticism by General Stanley A. McChrystal, commander of the International Security Assistance Force and U.S. Forces Afghanistan commander, about Vice President Joe Biden and other administration members of the White House. McChrystal resigned from his position shortly after his statements went public. In 2010, Taibbi documented illegal and fraudulent actions by banks in the foreclosure courts, after traveling to Jacksonville, Florida and sitting in on hearings in the courtroom. His article, "Invasion of the Home Snatchers," also documented attempts by the judge to intimidate a homeowner fighting foreclosure and the attorney Taibbi accompanied into the court. In January 2012, the magazine ran exclusive excerpts from Hastings' book just prior to publication. The book, "The Operators, The Wild and Terrifying Inside Story of America's War in Afghanistan," provided a much more expansive look at McChrystal and the culture of senior American military and how they become embroiled in such wars. The book reached Amazon's bestseller list in the first 48 hours of release, and it received generally favorable reviews. Salon's Glenn Greenwald described it as superb, brave and eye-opening. In 2012, Taibbi, through his coverage of the Lieber scandal, emerged as an expert on that topic, which led to media appearances outside Rolling Stone. On November 9, 2012, the magazine published its first Spanish-language section on Latino music and culture, in the issue dated November 22, 2016 to present, new ownership. In September 2016, Advertising Age reported that Winner is in the process of selling a 49% stake of the magazine to a company from Singapore called Ban Lab. The new investor had no direct involvement in the editorial content of the magazine. In September 2017, Winner Media announced that the remaining 51% of Rolling Stone magazine is up for sale. In December 2017, Penske Media acquired the remaining stake from Winner Media. On January 31, 2019, Penske acquired Ban Lab's 49% stake in Rolling Stone, gaining full ownership of the magazine. Covers. Some artists have been featured on the cover many times, and some of these pictures went on to become iconic. The Beatles, for example, have appeared on the cover more than 30 times, either individually or as a band. The magazine is known for provocative photography and has featured musicians and celebrities on the cover throughout its history. Vanity Fair called the January 22, 1981 cover featuring John Lennon and Yoko Ono the greatest Rolling Stone cover ever. The first 10 issues featured, in order of appearance, the following: John Lennon, Tina Turner, The Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, Donovan, and Otis Redding, Jim Morrison, Janis Joplin, Jimi Hendrix, Monterey Pop Festival, John Lennon and Paul McCartney, Eric Clapton. Print format. the printed format has gone through several changes. The first publications, in 1967-72, were in folded tabloid newspaper format, with no staples, black ink text, and a single color highlight that changed each edition. From 1973 onwards, editions were produced on a four-color press with a different newsprint paper size. In 1979, the barcode appeared. In 1980, it became a gloss paper, large format, 10x12, magazine. Editions switched to the standard 8x11 magazine size starting with the October 30, 2008 issue. Starting with the July 2018 issue, it returned to the previous 10x12 large format. Website. Rolling Stones maintains a website where it shares similar content to its print publication. The site at one time had an extensive message board form. By the late 1990s, this had developed into a thriving community, with many regular members and contributors worldwide. However, the site was also plagued with numerous internet trolls and malicious code hackers, who vandalized the forum substantially. The magazine abruptly deleted the forum in May 2004, then began a new, much more limited message board community on their site in late 2005, only to remove it again in 2006. In March 2008, the website started a new message board section once again, then deleted it in April 2010. Rolling Stone devotes one of its table of contents pages to promoting material currently appearing on its website, listing detailed links to the items. On April 19, 2010, the website underwent a redesign and began featuring the complete archives of Rolling Stone. The archive was first launched under a for-pay model, but has since transitioned to a free-with-print subscription model. In the spring of 2012, Rolling Stone launched a federated search feature which searches both the website and the archive. The website has become an interactive source of biographical information on music artists in addition to historical rankings from the magazine. Users can cross-reference lists and they are also provided with historical insights. For example, one group that is listed on both Rolling Stone's 500 Greatest Albums of All Time and Rolling Stone's 500 Greatest Songs of All Time is Toots and the Maytals, with biographical details from Rolling Stone that explain how Toots and the Maytals are responsible for coining the term reggae in their song Do the Reggae. For biographical information on all artists, the website contains a directory listed alphabetically. Clixel. In May 2016, Winner Media announced plans to create a separate online publication dedicated to the coverage of video games and video game culture. Gus Winner, Jan Winner's son and head of digital for the publication at the time, told the New York Times that gaming is today what rock and roll was when Rolling Stone was founded. Clixel was originally hosted on Rolling Stone's website and transitioned to its own domain by October 2016. Stories from Clixel are included on the Rolling Stone website, while writers for Rolling Stone were also able to contribute to Clixel. The site was headed by John Davison, and its offices were located in San Francisco. Rolling Stone closed down the offices in June 2017 and fired the entire staff, citing the difficulties of working with a remote site from their main New York office. Brian Crescenti, founder of Kotaku and co-founder of Bigger Polygon, was hired as editorial director and runs the site from the main New York office. Following the sale of Rolling Stone's assets to Penske Media Corporation, the Clixel content was merged into the routine publishing of Variety, with Crescenti remaining as editorial director. Editorial stance. Rolling Stone endorsed Democratic candidate Hillary Clinton in the run-up for the 2016 U.S. presidential election. Restaurant. In December 2009, The Los Angeles Times reported that the owners of Rolling Stone magazine planned to open a Rolling Stone restaurant in the Hollywood and Highland Center in Hollywood in the spring of 2010. The expectation was that the restaurant could become the first of a national chain if it was successful. As of November 2010, the soft opening of the restaurant was planned for December 2010. In 2011, the restaurant was open for lunch and dinner as well as a full nightclub downstairs on the weekends. The restaurant closed in February 2013. Criticism. One major criticism of Rolling Stone involves its generational bias toward the 1960s and 1970s. One critic referred to the Rolling Stone list of the 500 greatest songs as an example of unrepentant rockist fogyism. In further response to this issue, rock critic Jim DeRogatis, a former Rolling Stone editor, published a thorough critique of the magazine's lists in a book called Kill Your Idols, A New Generation of Rock Writers Reconsiders the Classics, which featured differing opinions from many younger critics. Rolling Stone magazine has been criticized for reconsidering many classic albums that it had previously dismissed, and for frequent use of the 3.5-star rating. For example, Led Zeppelin was largely written off by Rolling Stone magazine critics during the band's most active years in the 1970s, but by 2006, a cover story on the band honored them as the heaviest band of all time. A critic for Slate magazine described a conference at which 1984's The Rolling Stone Record Guide was scrutinized. As he described it, the guide virtually ignored hip-hop and ruthlessly panned heavy metal, the two genres that within a few years would dominate the pop charts. In an auditorium packed with music journalists, you could detect more than a few anxious titters. How many of us will want our record reviews read back to us 20 years hence? The hiring of former FHM editor Ed Needham further enraged critics who alleged that Rolling Stone had lost its credibility. The 2003 Rolling Stone's 100 Greatest Guitarists of All Time article, which named only two female musicians, resulted in Venus Zine answering with their own list, entitled The Greatest Female Guitarists of All Time. Conservative columnist Jonah Goldberg stated that Rolling Stone had essentially become the house organ of the Democratic National Committee. Rolling Stone editor Jan Wiener has made all of his political donations to Democrats. Rolling Stone's film critic, Peter Travers, has been criticized for his high number of repetitively used blurbs. Tsarnaev cover. The August 2013 Rolling Stone cover, featuring then accused, later convicted, Boston Marathon bomber Dzhokhar Tsarnaev, drew widespread criticism that the magazine was glamorizing terrorism and that the cover was a slap in the face to the great city of Boston. The online edition of the article was accompanied by a short editorial stating that the story falls within the traditions of journalism and Rolling Stone's long-standing commitment to serious and thoughtful coverage of the most important political and cultural issues of our day. The controversial cover photograph that was used by Rolling Stone had previously featured on the front page of the New York Times on May 5, 2013. In response to the outcry, New England-based CVS Pharmacy and Tedeschi Food Shops banned their stores from carrying the issue. Also refusing to sell the issue were Walgreens, Rite Aid and Kmart, Roche Brothers and Stop and Shop, HEB and Walmart, 7-Eleven, Hy-Vee, Rutter's Farm, and United Supermarkets, Cumberland Farms and Market Basket, and Shaw's. Boston Mayor Thomas Menino sent a letter to Rolling Stone publisher Jan Wiener, calling the cover ill-conceived. At best, it reaffirms a message that destruction gains fame for killers and their causes. Menino also wrote, "To respond to you in anger is to feed into your obvious market strategy," and that Wiener could have written about the survivors or the people who came to help after the bombings instead. In conclusion he wrote, "The survivors of the Boston Marathon deserve Rolling Stone cover stories, though I no longer feel that Rolling Stone deserves them." UVA false rape story. In the November 19, 2014 issue, the story A Rape on Campus was run about an alleged gang rape on the campus of the University of Virginia. Separate inquiries by Phi Kappa Psi, the fraternity accused by Rolling Stone of facilitating the alleged rape, and the Washington Post revealed major errors, omissions and discrepancies in the story. Reporter Sabrina Erdley's story was subject to intense media criticism. The Washington Post and Boston Herald issued calls for magazine staff involved in the report to be fired. Rolling Stone subsequently issued three apologies for the story. Some suggested that legal action against the magazine by persons accused of the rape might result. On December 5, 2014, Rolling Stone's managing editor, Will Dana, apologized for not fact-checking the story. Rolling Stone commissioned an outside investigation of the story and its problems by the dean of the Columbia School of Journalism. The report uncovered journalistic failure in the UVA story and institutional problems with reporting at Rolling Stone. Rolling Stone retracted the story on April 5, 2015. On April 6, 2015, following the investigation and retraction of the story, Phi Kappa Psi announced plans to pursue all available legal action against Rolling Stone, including claims of defamation. On May 12, 2015, UVA Associate Dean Nicole Aramo, Chief Administrator for Handling Sexual Assault Issues at the school, filed a $7.5 million defamation lawsuit in Charlottesville Circuit Court against Rolling Stone and Ridley, claiming damage to her reputation and emotional distress. Said the filing, Rolling Stone and Ridley's highly defamatory and false statements about Dean Aramo were not the result of an innocent mistake. They were the result of a wanton journalist who was more concerned with writing an article that fulfilled her preconceived narrative about the victimization of women on American college campuses, and a malicious publisher who was more concerned about selling magazines to boost the economic bottom line for its faltering magazine, than they were about discovering the truth or actual facts. On November 4, 2016, after 20 hours of deliberation, a jury consisting of 8 women and 2 men found Rolling Stone, the magazine's publisher, and Ridley liable for defaming Aramo. On July 29, 2015, 3 graduates of the fraternity Phi Kappa Psi filed a lawsuit against Rolling Stone, its publisher Winter Media, and a journalist for defamation and infliction of emotional distress. The same day, and just months after the controversy began, The New York Times reported that managing editor Will Dana was departing the magazine with his last date recorded as August 7, 2015. On November 9, 2015, the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity filed suit for $25 million for damages to its reputation caused by the magazine's publication of this story, with reckless disregard for the truth. In popular culture, George Harrison's song This Guitar, 1975, a lyrical sequel to his Beatles track While My Guitar Gently Weeps, 1968, references the magazine in its second verse, "Learn to get up when I fall, can even climb Rolling Stone walls." The song was written in response to some highly unfavorable reviews from Rolling Stone and other publications for Harrison's 1974 North American tour and the Dark Horse album. The 2000 film Almost Famous centers on a teenage journalist writing for the magazine in the early 1970s while covering the fictional Ben Stillwater. The film was directed by Cameron Crowe and based on his own experiences as a young journalist for the magazine in the same time period. The cover of Rolling Stone is a song written by Shel Silverstein and first recorded by American rock group Dr. Hook and The Medicine Show. The song satirizes success in the music business. The song's narrator laments that his band, despite having the superficial attributes of a successful rock star, including drug usage, teenage groupies, who'll do anything we say, and a frenetic guitar solo, has been unable to get their pictures on the cover of the Rolling Stone. International editions. Argentina, published by Pablo Revistas S. I since April 1998. This edition also circulates in Bolivia, Paraguay, and Uruguay. Australia, Rolling Stone Australia began as a supplement in 1969 in Revolution magazine. It became a full title in 1971 published by Philip Fraser. It was published by Silver Tongs from 1974 to 1987 and by Next Media Proprietary Limited, Sydney until 2008. Notable editors and contributors include Philip Fraser, Alistair Jones, Paul, and Jane Gardner, Toby Cresswell, Clinton Walker, and Kathy Bale. It was the longest-running international edition but closed in January 2018. Brazil, published in Brazil since October 2006 by Spring Comunicações. Bulgaria, published in Bulgaria since November 2009 by Sever Publications. Ceased publication as of the August-September 2011 issue. Chile, published by Edu Comunicaciones from May 2003 to December 2005. Published by El Mercurio from January 2006 to December 2011. China, Rolling Stone in mainland China was licensed to One Media Group of Hong Kong and published in partnership with China Record Corporation in 2006. The magazine was in Chinese with translated articles and local content. It halted publication after 1 year. Croatia, published since October 2013 to 2015 by S3 Medici. This edition also circulates in Bosnia and Herzegovina, North Macedonia, Montenegro, Serbia, and Slovenia. Colombia, edited in Bogota for Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, Panama, and Venezuela, since 1991. France, launched 2002. This edition temporarily ceased in 2007 and was relaunched in May 2008 under license with 1633 Subpublishing Group. Germany, published in Germany since 1994 by Axel Springer AG. India, launched in March 2008 by MW.com, publishers of Man's World magazine. Indonesia, published in Indonesia from June 2005 to January 1, 2018 by A&E Media. Italy, published in Italy since 1980. After ceasing publication in 1982, it was relaunched in November 2003, first by Exo Publishing, and then by Editors Quadratum until April 2014. The magazine is currently published by Luciano Bernardini de Pace Editor. It ceased print edition in 2019, moving online. Japan, launched in March 2007 by International Luxury Media Co., Ltd., ILM. Published by Atomix Media Incorporated, K.K. Atomix Su Media, since 2011. Mexico, published by Prisa International from 2002 until May 2009. From June 2009 it is published by Editorial Televisa, subsidiary of Televisa, under license. Middle East, published in Dubai by HGW Media since November 2010. Russia, published since 2004, by Motor Media. Spain, published by Progresa, subsidiary of Prisa Group, in Madrid, since 1999. Turkey, published since June 2006 by GD Gazette Turkey. South Africa, published since November 2011. United Kingdom, published under the title Friends from 1969 to 1972.